Hi there. So, this is a Nvidia Shield tablet, and I have no idea which model it is. It's the 8-inch. It tells you right here it's a 32GB LTE, and it is a Nvidia Tegra K1. So, a friend of mine owed me some money, or we did a little deal, a little bit of a swap, and this is what I got. Now, the issue is, this is broken, as you can see, and you cannot fit a SIM card in there. So the LTE functionality is gone. It does have 32 gigs on board, and it is basically a plain Jane tablet, I guess you could say. It has a stylus, which is pretty cool in my opinion. And I also got the controller with it. And at first when I got it, I thought, okay, I'm going to go out and play all these games. This will be fantastic. And I'm going to have so much fun with it. But you got to buy all the games that the controller needs. So the controller is now back in its box and it's going to end up on eBay. This thing, on the other hand, with no SIM card on it, you'll see up here in a second, the wireless is very flaky. So no Wi-Fi. I can try connecting, but it's not even seeing my Wi-Fi on here. Oh, now it's connected, kind of. Oh, now it's off. Connected? Connected. It was working fine for a couple days. Actually, when I first got it, the Wi-Fi wasn't connecting at all. So then I went on to various forums, and tried to find out what was going on. And there's updates and everything else you can get for it, but it just seems to be like either physically the card, or maybe it's just a software update, who knows. But it was driving me nuts, so it basically just sat there and I haven't done anything with it. This version is, let's go in here, runs 6.01, and the Shield tablet software version is 4.4. I think that is the most recent one, because I've done all the updates I can see here. Okay, so as of today, January 23rd, 4:42, it's updated. The Wi-Fi is on right now. The Wi-Fi is off right now. The Wi-Fi is on right now. The Wi-Fi is... Let's wait for it. It's going to be off in a minute. Anyway, now it's off. I don't know what to do with it. Well, I know exactly what I'm going to do with it. I'm going to sell it, but what am I going to be able to sell it for? Because it's got this broken piece over here. If it was able to connect to LTE, I would have no issues with it. Well, there are a few issues. And you know what? I'm just going to complain with this thing. I'm not even going to give it anything good. I'm just going to complain. The power button, sometimes when you shut off, it doesn't always turn back on. And when I do go to hit it, the gap here is so small that I don't know if I'm hitting the volume control or if I'm hitting the power button. It does have mini HDMI, which is awesome. This is the charging port, which is the micro USB. Works well. Headphones I have not tried out yet. I have tried some media, and it plays it well. So you can see it's got a speaker there, and I think this is a speaker grill as well. And there's a speaker grill over here and a speaker over here. I kind of like the matte back, though it seems to scratch up pretty easy. The camera is nothing to write home about. It takes lousy pictures, especially with a flash, because I guess the ISO can't get up fast enough. The pen, you will probably never use the pen. I can almost guarantee you that. Like, you pop it out, if you pop it out. It's kind of cool looking, because it has a bit of a wedge shape on it. It doesn't do anything, though. It's just a pen. So when I go into an app that does use it, I can actually get into one here. There it is, Dapple or something. That was my last drawing. It's fantastic. I don't know how to change the pen color. Nope. 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 No. How do I change the pen color? Doesn't tell you. What's this thing do over here? I don't know. There's this little dot over here. Oh, wait. What's that? Pen color. Ta-da. Okay, fantastic. Layers, maybe? I have no idea. Anyway, we won't get into details on this. I imagine that someone that finds this useful. Okay. Someone that may find that useful, it might work for them, but it does nothing for me. Now, since there's no internet, who knows? Oh, now the internet's on. Internet's off. Internet is on. Internet's on. Internet's off. I'm just frustrated with the whole damn thing. I don't know what to do with it. It's going to be for sale soon, so you can look for it on my eBay site. The controller, on the other hand, it's beautiful. It's comfortable. It's super. I really like it. And the best part is that you can connect it with this USB cable to your regular PC and providing you with a Nvidia video card, you can play games on it, and it just plugs in like a regular controller. So that, I thought, was the coolest part of the whole thing. And they're selling for extremely high prices, though, for some reason on eBay. I don't know why. That's the USB cable there. He never used it. And like him, I'll probably never use it. I guess if you were to plug it in via HDMI, for example, and ran like Grand Theft Auto on your TV, then yeah, it might be fun. Now, it is a quick little chip, like the chipset itself, when you get in there. So when I go and I play my regular games, for example, the Skydancer one seems kind of fun. It draws a lot of horsepower, though. Let's see if it loads anytime soon. Okay, tap to start. Did I tap? How many times am I tapping here? Did I tap again? You press both buttons to jump. Yes, I know. Press both buttons to jump. Oh, and I missed. And even this thing has a bit of, you can see there's a bit of lag, a bit of choppiness in the frames when running it. There you go. Do you want to close it? Yes. Maybe it just needs a restart. Who knows? But I have been restarting it. But boy, it's just so, I don't know. I'd rather have a Samsung tablet. That's all I really have to say about this. It looks good. It feels good. It's pretty comfortable as far as tablets go. I wish that the LTE port wasn't broken. Maybe that damaged something else on the inside. Who knows? And I find that the power key doesn't always work. I'm pressing and holding it now. Okay, we'll do a restart. Okay, so that took longer than I thought it would. So now it's into the restart mode. That probably took 3.5 minutes. That can't be normal. So anyway, while this thing reboots, let's take a look for a second here at the box. The packaging was nice. It's really, there's nothing in there though. Yeah, is there anything under there? Maybe it's a secret compartment. Nope. Print's so small that I'll never be able to read it. That's the AT&T thing going on about the LTE, which I can never connect to. Okay, so 192 core Kepler GPUs, 8-inch full HD LCD, 2 gigs of RAM, 32 gig storage, 8 to 11 ABGN, Bluetooth 4, 5 megapixel autofocus HDR rear, 5 megapixel user facing HDR camera, 3G, 4G. I'm sure if this was complete, it would be a nice little unit. SIM card. Now, let's see if it picks up the wireless. No Wi-Fi. Come on, pick up the Wi-Fi. Okay. Does that mean the Wi-Fi is on? When the Wi-Fi works, it is a great little plain Jane vanilla tablet. When the Wi-Fi doesn't work, it's a brick. Yeah, anyway, I'm working on a Raspberry Pi retro machine. We'll see how that goes too. That'd be one of my next videos. This retro Pi little unit. See, it's a little offline. It's a little sluggish online. See how long this lasts. I can't tell if it's on or off. Anyway, in this condition, it's not something I would recommend at all. If you want to buy it, it's going to be on eBay under consignment sales dash CA. Feel free to shoot me an offer. All offers will be reviewed. Lowballers will be humiliated. And that's it. I'm going to go cook my kids' supper. And if you have any questions, leave them below. Please subscribe. I would appreciate it. And we shall talk again. Thanks for watching.